Hey, Most Amazing Top 10 family, I'm Jada Reyna and I have Jared Bronstein joining me today on this show, and welcome to Most Amazing Top 10.
I don't know why I was doing that.
I don't know, I liked it though. What do you think of today's list?
I think it's gonna be a fun one, guys. I think you guys are gonna enjoy it. If you guys have any childhood movies that you're like, I watched that growing up as a child, I love that, well guess what? We're about to ruin it for you.
Yeah, we are gonna ruin it for you. It's gonna probably make you real sad. We're gonna pull out all the sad, dark moments of every video we could find of all these movies and stuff. And okay. Jared is, of course, here to shout out the channel.
Top 10 Central, guys, check it out. Click right over here. You guys saw me in a bunch of videos with Eamon. I did a couple with Abby. And I was like, you know what? Che's the best on the channel, so why wouldn't
I just collab with him? That's right. They finally, people are getting it now. They're getting it. Yes. And, of course, the video we are doing today is Top 10 Dark Moments in Kids Movies That Came Out of Nowhere.
Yeah, a lot of just depressing death.
And so much depressing death. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Also, stick around for the whole video because we're gonna have loads of bloopers at the end of this
Got
video.
Bloopers, baby!
So many bloopers for you guys. If you want some more Most Amazing Top 10 content, check us out on Instagram and Facebook. We are starting to do Facebook exclusive content. And anyone who wants merch, check out the link in the description below and use the offer code MA10 that will give you $5 off. Without taking any longer, let's get into this list.
Bam! Yeah.
At the number 10 spot, we have the beginning of Up. Yeah, let's start off this list with one of the most depressing moments in movie history. This scene is so sad that the music from it has been used in every depressing meme for the last 5 years. This moment in movie history is so dark that the ripples have been felt through our culture to this day. Let's break it down. A couple falls in love. They were made for each other. It's the real kind of love, like the love you see in the streets that gives you a warm feeling in your soul. Then they want to have a baby. Beautiful, but they can't have babies. They both find out that she is unable to have kids and his wife starts going into a depression. But they still have each other. So they start working on a new dream, an adventure. They start saving for this adventure, but they have a few setbacks, but they keep on pushing. Time passes, then they grow old, and they forget about the adventure. But then her husband remembers. So even though they're old, they can still go. He buys a ticket for them to go on this adventure, and then she dies. The movie gives you true love, and then rips it away within the first 10 minutes. What kind of monster puts this into a kids' movie? At the Pixar meeting where they pitch this, they're probably like, you know what we haven't done? Make the viewer cry at the start.
In at number 9 on the list, Clayton's death in Tarzan. After shooting one of Tarzan's best pals, Clayton the gorilla hunter realizes his job will be much easier with Tarzan out of the way. So he decides to go after Tarzan with his double barrel shotgun. That's not the dark, scary part though. After a few moments of Tarzan jumping from tree to tree and vine to vine, he eventually strips Clayton of his gun. However, Clayton, well aware that Tarzan could drop him, decides to then pull out a machete. After getting wrapped up in vines, which was Tarzan's way of protecting himself from the crazy gorilla hunter, Clayton starts to use the machete to free himself. As he's cutting, you can hear Tarzan begging Clayton to stop, which, of course, he doesn't. Eventually, you see Clayton cut all the vines except the one around his neck, which tightens. Then you see Clayton falling out of the sky, a shot of the vine presumably around his neck straighten out, Tarzan and Clayton's machete fall to the ground, and, well, Clayton's body doesn't fall to the ground. That's right, guys. As a kid, we all witnessed someone die from hanging. That's lovely.
At number 8, we have attempted suicide. The Incredibles is probably my favorite Pixar movie of all time. It's just amazing. Now, at the beginning of the movie, there's a flashback that highlights the heroes and what they look like in what seems to be the 70s. It intros all the heroes while they're still allowed to operate in the public. It's mostly following Mr. Incredible as he saves people. One of the people he saves is a man attempting to commit suicide by jumping off a massive building. This then leads to a massive lawsuit, followed by a series of lawsuits which forces heroes to go into hiding. But the part that is always glossed over is the fact that a man tried to kill himself. That's a lot for a kid's movie. Even though Mr. Incredible saves this dude, he was suicidal. What was he going through? What were his thoughts? It is never acknowledged.
Now at number 7, Mufasa's murder. I don't know about you guys, but as a kid, and even to this day, The Lion King was and always will be one of my favorite Disney films. Music was great, the story was also very fun. Yet one that always stood out to me and of course scared me to death was the scene when a lion plummets to its death. But it's not any lion. No, it's the father of the movie's main character, who you grow to adore and feel so much love for. So you're sitting here watching a cub and his heroic lion father be all cute, and then bam, Mufasa and Scar are fighting, and the next thing you know, this heroic lion is literally hanging off of a cliff by his paw. It's sad, but there's still some hope he makes it. You're like hoping that there's like some sort of heroic moment that Simba will come and push Scar off. That doesn't happen. This guy's brother, not some other random lion, it's his brother, digs his claws into Mufasa's. This leads to Mufasa yelling out in pain, ultimately losing his grasp of the edge of the cliff and falling to his horrific death. To make matters worse, Scar then blames Simba for his own father's death. Imagine seeing that as a child. Even now, I'm getting worked up, but as a kid, I was like petrified. I was so scared that I literally just saw two animals kill each other. Well, I guess murder one. And then he blamed it on his kid. As a child, do you know the anxiety you have of like losing your parent and then just watching that happen on the screen and you can't do anything about it? And imagine it's your uncle doing it to your father. It's just gross.
At number six, we've got Artax stuck in the mud. All right, now onto the never-ending story. This scene is still stuck in my head from when I was a kid. You have a young boy named Atreyu traveling through the Swamp of Sadness with his best friend and horse, Artax. They are looking for the Ancient One, Morla. Something very important about the Swamp of Sadness is that it's magical, and if you let the sadness take you over, then you are going to get swallowed up into the swamp like a hot dog in front of Joy Chestnut. The journey is difficult, but the two are making good progress, and then something happens to Artax. He stops moving. The sadness of the swamp is starting to consume the poor horse. I didn't even know horses could get sad. I thought they only had two moods that were like run and kick. So Artax starts to sink into the mud, and then the audience has to watch a kid watch the only thing he loves, his best friend, his main companion, drown in a swamp. This is all happening as a kid screams out to the horse to try and save him, and if that wasn't enough, we got to watch a kid weep alone, covered in mud.
Moving on to the number five spot, the Toy Story 3 Incinerator. I mean, there's a reason that everyone was crying when they saw this in movie theaters. They literally almost watched some of their favorite childhood characters get burned alive. And we're talking adults here, people in their 20s and 30s breaking down. So imagine if you're a legitimate child, you see these talking toys, they're now your best friends, bam, you see them moments away from complete destruction. If the fact that they were almost burned in front of your eyes wasn't bad enough, what actually happens in the movie makes it even harder. After the team works together and gets Lotso high enough to reach the emergency stop button, he just cuts. He doesn't stop anything, he just leaves, he wants them all to die. So here we all are, all worried, the team finds a solution, only for it to not be a solution. Then they all just hold hands and accept that they're all gonna die. I know they don't die, but that's irrelevant. People were also coming up with their own theories, comparing this film to the Holocaust, which just makes this scene that much worse. Like, I feel like they could have written so many other things, rather than just literally being put in an area to just be burnt alive, and they're all holding hands like, all right guys, well this is it. That's like, that's hard to watch as anybody, forget a kid, really anyone.
For the number four spot, we have Bambi's mom dies. You thought you were gonna have a good life as a kid, well good luck dealing with the trauma that comes with watching your mother die in front of you. There isn't enough friendly skunks in the whole world to help you get over that. The movie Bambi kicks off with Bambi and her mom enjoying the budding signs of spring. Finally, winter is over and they will be able to frolic in the lush green before you know it. And then you hear a gunshot and Bambi and his mom have to run for their lives. Then Bambi makes it to safety, but where's his mom? Then you have to watch Bambi walk through the cold, calling out to his mom. It's a blizzard and his mom is nowhere to be found. You then have this little guy searching and searching until he comes across a random buck who tells him that your mother can't be with you anymore. That's how he finds out his mom's dead. I had to rewatch this scene to make this video, but for some reason I remember Bambi actually finding his dead mom's body, but in the version I watched, I couldn't find it. So maybe this was changed, or maybe this is just the Mandela effect in my brain. I can't remember. Let me know in the comments.
Now, number three, we got the hanging rats in Ratatouille. In a hope to prove to the film's main character, Remy, that humans can't be trusted, his father takes him to a pest control shop. Now, the issue with said shop is that in the window, you can clearly see dozens of dead rats being hung up for display. Now, I understand that a rat and a human are completely different things, at least 9 times out of 10. What I don't understand is how any child could watch a film about a talking rat who wants to become a chef, and in that same film, see a window full of rat corpses. Although this was actually a nod or a shout out to a real store in Paris that actually has dead rats hanging in the window, I don't think it's something that any kid should ever really see. Ever. Being a kid is all about the good in life, so why are we trying to introduce death at such a young age? Like, it's inevitable, but still, why include a bunch of hanging rat corpses? Like, it's no different than human corpses for a child. A dead body's a dead body, regardless.
At number two, we have the Younglings. Now, I debated putting this one on the list because I don't know if Star Wars could be considered a kid's movie, but my 6-year-old nieces love it so much, so I'm gonna say it counts. Also, I just wanted to put this on the list. For those of you who don't know, I'm gonna do a very quick recap. In Star Wars Episode 3, the Order was given out to betray the Jedi, and then they all start dying, and Anakin is now full evil. All the the clone troopers are tasked with killing Jedi, where Anakin is tasked with going into the Jedi temple and killing all the younglings. He has to slaughter like 15 kids. What the hell, dude? There wasn't even a thought of maybe convincing them to join the dark side, like restart them as Sith younglings. You just go straight to cutting them into pieces. Oh my god, that scene is so gruesome. And it's really sent home by how much the kids still trust him. We see the cutest little chubby-cheeked kid say to Anakin, "Master Skywalker, there are too many of them. What are we going to do?" Right before Anakin draws his saber to cut them down.
Now in at the top on our list at number one, Home Alone. It's a classic Christmas movie that we love to watch every year. An 8-year-old Kevin is accidentally left home alone while his family goes on vacation. When Kevin's mother realizes she left him home alone, she does what she can to get back to him ASAP, all while Kevin has to fend off two thieves trying to break into his house. And although Kevin does fend the two off for the most part, eventually they find their way in. After falling for a handful of Kevin's traps, they manage to capture the cunning 8-year-old and hang him up on a coat rack using his sweater. Now in a vulnerable position, the two thieves start listing off the things they're going to do to this helpless 8-year-old. Thankfully, Kevin's neighbor comes in the nick of time to save the day, just moments before Harry bites off Kevin's fingers one by one, as he promised to do just moments before. And although 8-year-old Kevin wasn't physically harmed, could we just all just take a moment to understand we were literally seconds away from a grown man biting off an 8-year-old's fingertips? Especially during a home invasion? That's so goddamn awful. Even as a grown man, that's absolutely terrifying. Why was that in the film?
Alright guys, thank you so much for checking out this video. Make sure you check out Top 10 Central.
Yeah, we got some laughs, we got Eamon on there, we got Landon, we got some familiar faces. I mean, I'm not technically part of the Most Amazing Top 10 fam, but like...
But here you're an honorary member.
Like, I've been in enough videos lately that I kinda am now at this point.
We love him here at Most Amazing Top 10. As always guys, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Till next time, I've been Jade Arena.
Sorry. Bruh, I'm right here.
Until next time, I've been Jade Arena.
I'm Jared Bronstein.
And I gotta watch more horrible kids movies just to, for my own soul, I guess, ruin my day one day.
Yeah, I still think Mufasa is like the saddest one.
Yeah, that's probably the saddest
one.
Okay, bye.